This video demonstrates a modeling activity with crocheted pieces to illustrate the process of lateral folding of the embryonic disc. These are the pieces. There's one yellow endoderm piece, one pink mesoderm piece with lateral split edges and two shorter pink mesoderm lateral extension pieces, one blue long ectoderm piece and two shorter blue ectoderm lateral extension pieces, one black notochord piece, two pink paraxial mesoderm column pieces, and one blue neural tube piece. Note that the strings and eyelets do not have embryonic correlates. They are the means of attaching the model pieces together. Note also that this model represents only a segment of the middle of the germ disc, not the entire disc. We'll start by building the trilaminar disc. The yellow piece represents the endoderm, which will give rise to the inner lining of the gut tube and airways. Again, keep in mind that this piece represents only a segment of the middle of the germ disc, and the strings and eyelets are just the means of attaching the model pieces together. The long pink piece represents the mesoderm, which will give rise to muscle, bone, and other tissues. The ends are already split, foreshadowing future changes. The mesoderm layer is dorsal to the endoderm. I'll secure it in place with the strings and eyelets. This blue piece represents the ectoderm, which will give rise to the nervous system and the epidermis of the skin. The ectoderm layer is dorsal to the mesoderm. For the moment, I'll just put it in place to create the trilaminar disc, which forms in the third week of development. Again, the three layers, from ventral to dorsal, are the endoderm, mesoderm, and ectoderm. Before securing the ectoderm in place, I'll add in a few more structures that will form during lateral folding. The black piece represents the notochord, a signaling source that induces the development of the axial skeleton and the nervous system. The notochord goes right in midline. The two pink columns represent the paraxial mesoderm, which will give rise to the axial skeleton, skeletal muscle, and the dermis of the skin. The paraxial mesoderm forms lateral to the notochord. The blue tube represents the neural tube, which is induced to form by the notochord and will give rise to the central nervous system. The neural tube forms from the ectoderm and is located dorsal to the notochord. Now I'll secure the ectoderm in place with the strings and eyelets. Let's pause to note how this model relates to the corresponding figure from your textbook. The model shows structures derived from the germ disc, separate from the neighboring cavities. The ectoderm layer is continuous with the lining of the amniotic cavity, and the endoderm layer is continuous with the lining of the yolk sac. Some structures in the model foreshadow their configuration at the completion of lateral folding. The notochord and paraxial mesoderm should be in the same plane as the rest of the mesoderm at this point, and the neural tube should not have completely separated from the ectoderm yet, but placing these structures in this configuration now allows us to focus on the process of lateral folding. Now that the trilaminar disc is assembled, with some foreshadowing structures, we can continue with lateral folding. Note that the following processes of growth and folding proceed roughly simultaneously, but the model will illustrate one process at a time. As lateral folding begins, the lateral plate mesoderm splits into two layers, the visceral or splanchnic mesoderm ventrally, and the parietal or somatic mesoderm dorsally. The endoderm pinches off from the yolk sac and forms the gut tube, and the visceral mesoderm folds closely around it. I'll use the string and eyelets to fuse the lateral sides of the endoderm together. In the model, the gut tube is now closed. This layer will give rise to the inner lining of the gastrointestinal tract and the airways. The visceral mesoderm folds closely around the gut tube. The visceral mesoderm will give rise to the smooth muscle and connective tissue surrounding the gastrointestinal tract and airways. It will also form the heart. The parietal mesoderm and ectoderm both must elongate before they can complete lateral folding. The short pink pieces and short blue pieces represent the lateral extensions of the parietal mesoderm and ectoderm, respectively. The lateral sides of the parietal mesoderm and ectoderm both fold ventrally and fuse together in midline. I'll start with the parietal mesoderm. Note that the parietal and visceral mesoderm layers are continuous with each other dorsally, and that a space, the body cavity, is created between the parietal mesoderm and visceral mesoderm. The parietal mesoderm will give rise to the membranes that surround the body cavity and the bones of the appendicular skeleton. Finally, I'll complete the lateral folding of the ectoderm, which will form the epidermis of the skin. The neural tube, which separated from the ectoderm during lateral folding, will give rise to the central nervous system. Lateral folding is now complete. Let's compare the model with the corresponding figure from your textbook. The model represents the embryo, which is suspended within the amniotic cavity. Inside, there is a gut tube, derived from the endoderm, which will give rise to the inner lining of the gastrointestinal tract and airways. The gut tube is closely surrounded by visceral mesoderm, which will give rise to smooth muscle and connective tissue, as well as the heart. A body cavity separates the visceral mesoderm from the parietal mesoderm. The parietal mesoderm will form membranes of the body wall and the bones of the limbs. Looking dorsally, the notochord is a signaling structure in midline. Lateral to the notochord is the paraxial mesoderm, which segments into somites, which will give rise to the axial skeleton, skeletal muscle, and the dermis of the skin. Dorsal to the notochord is the neural tube, which will form the central nervous system. The outer layer of the embryo is the ectoderm, which will form the epidermis of the skin. This entire embryo is suspended in the amniotic cavity. Thank you for watching. Hopefully, this model demonstration helps you visualize the process of lateral folding and relate the involved structures to their derivatives.